Hey Chi Alpha, it's Duncan. It's good to be with you. Man, I sure do miss everybody. I know we all do. A lot of you guys are back home and enjoying summer. I hope it's going well. Greeley is a little bit quieter without all the shenanigans, our weekly stuff that we got going on. But it's been nice so far. Lori and I have been doing a lot of gardening, and we're actually kind of freaking out a little bit, hoping that the gardening we've done survives this little mini winter we just had. So hopefully the winter didn't hit you too hard these last couple of weeks. But Colorado summer, right? We are going to be coming to you weekly with what we're just calling our weekly VidCast, video blog, whatever you want to call it. And it's just a time every week where one of us is just going to share a little bit from our devotional lives. And in order to just kind of keep us all thinking about Jesus while we're away from each other over the summer, it's so important to have your own walk with God. It's so important to cultivate your own walk. You can't just walk with God only when you're in Chi Alpha, but you have to have your own. And this summer is just a great time to look at your life and ask yourself, do I have my own walk with God? But we also do need each other, and we need each other's walks in our lives. And so each week, one of us is just going to share a little bit about what's going on in our lives and what God is saying. So today, it's not going to take too long. I'll read a scripture, talk a little bit about it, and we'll be done. So today I'm going to read from John 15, and I'm going to be reading from my Claymore here, my fire Bible. And it's one of a couple Claymores I have, but this one's a pretty good one. But so starting in John 15, just starting in verse 1, and you can read along or you can just listen. It's up to you. But John 15 says this. And this is Jesus talking right here. He says, I am the true vine, and my Father is the vine dresser. Every branch in me that does not bear fruit, he takes away. And every branch that does bear fruit, he prunes, that it may bear more fruit. Already you are clean because of the word I have spoken to you. Abide in me, and I in you. As the branch cannot bear fruit by itself unless it abides in the vine, neither can you unless you abide in me. I am the vine, and you are the branches. Whoever abides in me, and I in him, he it is that bears much fruit. For apart from me you can do nothing. If anyone does not abide in me, he is thrown away like a branch and withers. And the branches are gathered, thrown into the fire, and burned. If you abide in me, and my words abide in you, ask whatever you wish, and it will be done for you. By this my Father is glorified, that you bear much fruit, and so prove to be my disciples. As the Father has loved me, so I loved you. Abide in my love. If you keep my commandments, you will abide in my love, just as I have kept my Father's commandments and abide in his love. These things I have spoken to you, that my joy may be in you, and that your joy may be full. This is my commandment, that you love one another as I have loved you. Greater love has no one than this, that someone lay down his life for his friends. You are my friends if you do what I command you. No longer do I call you servants, for the servant does not know what his master is doing. But I have called you friends. For all that I heard from my Father, I have made known to you. You did not choose me, but I chose you and appointed you that you should go and bear fruit, and that your fruit should abide, so that whatever you ask the Father in my name, he may give it to you. These things I command you, so that you will love one another. So I'll stop there. Jesus is talking here, and there's a lot to say here. Honestly, there's a lot theologically we can say. There's a lot from these verses that help form how we think about God and what our role is to play. And I just want to hit a few points and then we'll be done. So the first thing I want to talk about is just this idea of abiding. Jesus says this over and over again, abide in me. He says, abide in my love. That word abide, I think we all know what it means. It means to remain in. So we don't believe in like an experiential Christianity where like you go from experience to experience. Like some people say, come to our worship experience. Well, we don't believe worship is an experience. We believe that worship is a choice. It's a choice you make to worship. You choose to worship. And so we don't believe in this like chasing after feelings or goosebumps or experiences. To abide in Jesus is to remain in him in the good times and the bad times, when you're feeling it and when you're not feeling it. This is what we believe a true walk with God is. And, you know, Jesus is a real person. You know, he's not just your religious figure. He's a friend. In this verse, he says, "No longer do I call you my servants, but I call you my friends." This worldview that we have is very unique compared to some of the other worldviews out there. The other worldviews don't see their God as their friend necessarily, but we see Jesus as closer than a brother. So to abide in Jesus, and then he says, abide in my love. And he defines what that means. What does it mean to abide in his love? He says, very practically, it is to keep the commandments. He says, verse 10, if you keep my commandments, you will abide in my love, just as I have kept my Father's commandments and abide in his love. This is a big deal, to keep the commandments. And you know, the commandments, they aren't this thing where it's like we do a checklist every week and, you know, I followed this rule, I followed that rule, I broke that rule, but there's grace. That's not how we see the commandments. We see the commandments as an expression of God's love. We've talked about this before, but if you're going to be friends with God, there are rules to that, just like any friendship. And so he's laid out what those rules are, and it's our job to be obedient to those rules because we love Jesus and we want to be with him. So abide in his love by keeping the commandments. And then lastly, he says this is one of the most amazing, most profound things that Jesus says. He says, where is it? Verse 13, greater love has no one than this, than someone lay down his life for his friends. And then he says, you are my friends if you do what I command you. So how do we know we're friends with Jesus? If our love for him compels us to obey what he says. And greater love has no one this than someone lay down his life for his friends. Jesus demonstrates this for us through the cross. No one took his life from him. He willfully laid it down. And he demonstrates what this love is for us. And so what an amazing word. You know, we are the branches and he is the vine. And God is this gardener, the vine dresser. And if we're connected with Jesus, if we abide in Jesus, if we remain in him, we will bear fruit. And even if we do bear fruit, if we bear fruit, we're not going to be cut off and thrown into the fire. So that's good. But even if we do bear fruit, we're going to be pruned. And pruning is important. We believe that the Lord gives and he also takes away. And pruning is not a bad thing. When something gets pruned, it actually grows back fuller and more beautiful. And so if you're growing a rose bush, the only way for the rose bush to grow roses is if you prune it. I had to have a bunch of trees recently in my yard trimmed and pruned. There's a lot of dead stuff on them. And the truth is if you don't prune your trees, they're all going to die. The nutrients that it gathers from the soil, the tree tries to send it to those dead areas first to try to revitalize them. But some branches are dead. They're not going to be revitalized. And so allow God to prune in your life. Even if you are a Christian, if you're bearing fruit, even if you're remaining in him, he will still want to prune your life so that you will grow. Allow him to take things away. Just as much as you allow him to give you things. You know, it says in here that if you ask anything in his name, if you're abiding in Jesus, if you ask anything in his name, he will give it to you. When the same token, let him also take away. Because if you let him do that, it's only that much better for you. So anyway, that's kind of all we had for today. I hope that wherever you are, this word finds you and brings you life. We'll have another one next week, but my prayer for you is that you abide in Jesus this week. And until we meet again, love you. And if you're in town, we'll see you on Thursday. Okay, bye-bye. It's always you.